Thank you for always coming. So yeah, that's amazing. Have a good night, sleep well. You don't have to be a night owl like me. All right, so we want to do, what the hell do we want to do? We want to do, I keep forgetting things. Armor defense one. What does that need? Oh, I have some QR on it. Okay, so I'll just give you the theory because I'm not gonna click this blueprint. It's not an actual very good blueprint to click. So you see the sales number? Okay, so whenever you craft anything, you want to look at the product that it's producing. So the product here is defense enhancers, and you can kind of see how much was sold per day. So our weekly sales are 210, which translates to say 20 to 30 ped TT sold per day. So the sales are very low, 20 to 30 TT. So let's assume I crafted. Oh, by the way, crafting enhancers, you always want your thingamajig, this little slider, to be on quantity, because it doesn't give you more than one enhancer each time. So if you craft on condition, the rest of it will just be in residue, and that's a waste of markup, huge waste of markup. So don't do that. Don't do condition on enhancers. There are some things where condition makes more sense. There's some things where quantity makes more sense. And there's some other things where, like, sort of in between makes more sense, usually around here. So I'll leave that up to you guys to explore. But the idea is you want to put it between quantity or condition based on the markup that you will receive. So if you notice that you get better MU here, then you keep your quantity, you keep your slider here. If you notice you get better MU here, keep it there. But then you say, but more, it's all gambling. Well, since Loot 2.0, everything gets returned, and in the long run, it's about 97.3%. So, and by the way, that's fact because it's released by MA for the people who cycle a lot. Yeah. Hold on, thinking. So then, if you know that's always going to be your TT return, you just slide this to wherever it is to get you the best markup, and then you sell that. Okay, so now here's an item that's not worth selling. I'll give you an example. Durable dampener. All right, let's go. If you ever see items like this, they don't sell. The markup is an illusion. Let's give another example. That's not too crazy. Okay, so standard matrix. So you might look at this and go, oh, 120%. It only takes in 105 here, maybe 102 here, which is really, really cheap. Let's craft some standard matrix. Now, the thing with standard matrix, let's go take a look. You notice how there's one listing there? I bet this won't even sell. Because people buy, let's go take a look. Let's go to week. So there's two sales in this week. One of them was set 27 ped. The other one was 15 ped. So then if you think you can sell this amount by listing sort of a big stack like this for 114, you're not gonna sell that. It's gonna basically expire. So the only things that would sell here would be small stacks under 30 ped. 60 ped seems to be the highest, actually. 60, 17. So between like 15 to 70-ish. So yeah, nobody would buy that, basically. Unlucky for this guy. And majority of it is around 20 ped. So you could do it if you had like 20 ped TT. So that's how you do standard matrix, for example. And then if you want, yeah, if you're like an actual gamer, this is like totally not very gamer like, but oh yeah, damage and armor enhancers. So let's take a look at armor enhancers. Armor enhancer one. Okay, so you see all of these that are listed here? Let's take a look. So 20 to 30 pet are sold per day. So yeah, you can list. So if you list armor enhancers, you can either do what this guy is doing. So list like 10 or maybe 8. You can play with the numbers so you can get the margin, the percentages exactly where you want it to be at. So you might put like 9 enhancers, 8 enhancers, 12 enhancers, whatever the amount is, and you gotta play with the stack amount. Maybe 12 is good, I don't know, but you gotta play with it. It's not really my market. And yeah, you just list it. You beat everyone's prices, or you can list in small stacks and do this. But you have to do exploring. You have to do exploring. And then just always know that how much is sold per day, and use that to judge your stack sizes. Ugh. Okay, hope that worked out. I didn't bore too many people. It was like a financial lesson. Did it help in some way? All right, let's stick this stuff in here. Hey, thanks for the follow, Vaf. Much appreciated. That's what confuses me. Well, what confused you? Oh, give me some feedback as I'm talking. I don't know if you guys are understanding me otherwise. Oh, yeah. Okay, so we got a bunch of sensors. Let's say I want to sell this. Yuan, makes sense? Cool. What doesn't make sense? Bam, bam. I'll do another quickie. Music sensor. I actually use these for crafting. But we'll sell some as well. So sensor sell. Oh, this is good. 400 pet a day. So we can sell any stack we want. And sensors. And then we see how much are sold. 50 pet, 60 pet, 16, 9. All right, so the price amount between for this thing is between... I guess there is still 100 pet sales, but very low. So if you stick it in a stack higher than 100, you have a very low chance of selling. And you want this one maybe, I don't know, like 60? I'll do 60 pet. I'll beat everyone's prices and do 60. Now, how many of this is it? I don't know. Let's guess. 2,000. Let's stick another 1,000 in there. 500? Ah, perfect. And then we can price it, because you see all the small stacks are already really cheap, so if we want to sell in 60, we have to do lowest price. And then, it doesn't seem like it's dropping, so we can just do it slightly lower, and that's how you undercut people. Yeah, and that's fine. So that should sell. Okay, go away, go away, go away. All right, you pay more in materials to craft than what you get back is of what I earn. You pay more in materials to craft than what I get back what you earn. Oh, some things are not worth crafting. Like, there's a lot of things that suck. Like, for example, there's standard plate. So this thing takes iron and oil. Oh, actually, it might be good right now to do standard plate. No, that's standard matrix. My bad. Standard plate. So it takes Belkar and oil. So oil is what? 0.2. Belkar is what? 0.6. So this is really heavy in the weight of the markup. So you get like 75% of it, you pay like 112, which is crazy high. And the plate themselves sell at, this is an outlier, so I don't believe that. So let's say it sells maybe 111. You're not gonna profit from this, because Belkar is too high for you to make any margins off of standard plate. Yeah, so you have to calculate input markup versus output markup. Is it at least a difference of 4%? Because if you can do 4%, you can, in the long run, break even. If you can't do 4%, then in your long run, you're gonna probably lose. Oh, which is why EP is not good. So if you wanna click and some people might think, oh, but explosive projectiles. I just buy these nano cubes for like TT, and then I sell my stuff for markup. What a great deal. Well, no, it doesn't fit the 104% margin. So even if you sell that, let's say explosive projectiles. So explosive projectile is under one. It's like 102. And if you want to sell in big stacks, maybe you can hit. That doesn't make any sense for pricing. Yeah, 104% maybe. So 102 to 104. But then it doesn't add up. And then you get residue, which is like 101 or 102. Okay, so armor defense 1 is bad. Yes, Bam Bam. Don't craft armor defense 1. Armor defense, you only craft if you want to do your daily missions. I sometimes abandon that mission because it's just not good. Like, it's a big loss. A lot of the daily missions actually is a big loss. So like, you get your tokens, but you... I mean, in crafting anyway. So you get your tokens, but the crafted stuff for the daily missions suck. Like, just straight up suck. If you want to craft enhancers, I'll give you a good one to craft. You want damage enhancers. Now, you might go, but Moreykz, the blueprints are freaking expensive and they're non-existent. They're non-existent because they're actually profitable. And then if you click one of these, let's say, I'll show you. You might go, oh, but it takes output amplifiers and it takes pyrite and it takes Nova fragments. So the markup on those are insane. But then you say, you gotta remember, the weight of a output amplifier. So if I go output amp, they're each only 0.4 of a ped, and oh god, I gotta search the thing up again. Damn it. And then pyrite is, how much are they each? They're each, I don't know how much they're each, but it looks like it's like 1.5 ped each or something. Actually, I have pyrite. What am I doing? I got pyrite in here somewhere. Where the hell's my pyrite? But anyways, so it's 1.5 ped. So then if you click that, the weight of those two things compare it to... the weight of those things compare it to the socket 3 component, which is really low markup, compared to the empty enhancer component, which is basically 2 ped TT, your input markup might only be 150% or 160-70%, but your output markup is about 300%, because that's what damage enhancers sell for. So yeah, 300 and something percent. The cheapest ones are 300, but then they're also in massive stacks that you never really want to sell the big stacks if you want to profit. But yeah, so let's say you're making 300. So yeah, you have a nice 100% margin, at least. So these are good. Ace, hey, welcome. How do I find those damage enhancer blueprints? By clicking enhancer stuff. That's how you find them. Or you buy from people. But if you want to buy it or actually do well in enhancer crafting, try to get your hands on something with quality rating. So you want, like what I do in blueprints is I go to blueprints. I see whatever is worth buying. I just open everything. Just drop by quality, and by the way, only unlimited. So I just drop by quality. Now you kind of see what's available. Usually the high quality ones are all like retarded blueprints. All right, so let's see if there's anything good. Standard plate you might want if you, yeah. The quality of 100 are always more expensive. So let's see, basic sensor, slight profit there. Tech Gizmo 5. Oh, this is good. I would bid on that one. Okay. Yeah, but the good blueprints with high quality rating is very hard to find. It's usually non-existent. Yeah, they're usually non-existent. This one you could buy, level 3 amplifier blueprint. Okay. But yeah, so that's how you like do blueprint shopping. But you gotta know your markups inside and out. If you want to get in crafting and do well, you gotta not only know like the crafted materials, but you also gotta know the resources and how the blueprints market work. It's been a while, by the way. I've been playing Dota and WoW Underlords. WoW and Dota Underlords. That was dyslexia at its finest, right there. Hope those games are fun. Well, it's nice to have you joining us again. We started talking math, and like everybody didn't, who are not interested in math, just left. Okay, we gotta do our. Oh yeah, hold on. So we don't overkill the Dikebuzz too hard. Cause we gotta do some Dikebuzz. Let's use SB10. I want to just sell it. Let's do something that doesn't sell well. You. Is this where my amplifier is? Oh, I lost my milliamp. That's where it is. Okay, we'll just use that. Let's go to Icarus. Juan's, sorry, I missed what you said earlier. You said, but you also need to get bankroll. Yeah, I need a little bit, but you can actually do it with low bankroll on some of the blueprints. Like damage enhancers, if you get one blueprint and just focus on like one of the damage enhancers, don't need to do the whole suite of it. You only need like 1,000 ped. So it's not a lot. And of course, I'm assuming you got your skills already. If you want to do, let's say, a blueprint like the basic sensors, maybe you only need 500 ped, because it's a cheaper. And yeah, quality rating matters a lot. I don't want you to remember where the Dicobas are, but like, they're around this area. You thought basic sensors were bad? I forgot what the blueprints was. What did basic sensor need? Actually, I can just Google it. Oh, by the way, there's also a lot of misinformation in EU. Because the people who are crafting, they'll make things sound like they're bad. If you ever ask a really big crafter, they'll make it sound hard. Because it's good. I just don't do it because mining is also good. Okay, honestly, where are the Dagobahs at? I think they were back here, maybe. Okay, let's see. Ah, right now, basic sensor is very bad. Oh, that's why it's also going up in price. I crafted my basic sensors back when Belcar was like 101%. So it was a long time ago that I clicked it. But right now the input would be average about 107%, 108%. So let's say the input is 108%. Your output is 128%. And then assuming a third of it turns into one third of your crafted stuff turn into actual products, the other two thirds become residue, which is usually what it is. Yeah, you can still profit. The margins will be like a few percent, but you can still profit.